Hey guys, I just wanted to take a minute out of my day and go over my product that I've been promoting this week called Baze Hair RX. It's two different formulas that I put together for dry, tired, damaged hair. The reason why I came up with this is I was becoming more and more disappointed with the stuff that was available in the stores for my daughter's really dry and hard to manage hair. Not only was I disappointed with the price of those products, but also the poor quality I got when I was using them on their hair. So that's how I ended up creating this product. I have two different lines that I'm offering. The first one is Baze Hair RX Original Formula. It's more of a yellowish color. It has an almond scent to it. This product I would use for people who are just lacking that rejuvenated hair look, the shininess, the healthiness part of it. This replenishes moisture that's been lost out of just heat damage and just regular wear and tear on your hair. The second line I have is Baze Hair RX Extra Strength Version. This one is for more people who have really a lot of color damage, stuff where it's breaking down that hair cuticle and going into the hair shaft. It's infused with vitamins A and E, and it also has some protein to help rebuild that hair. You can find these products available off of my Facebook page, www.facebook.com/baze-hair-rx.com. So I'm going to show you guys how to do Baze hot oil treatment with Baze Hair RX. Some of the things that I would recommend you use, but you don't necessarily have to have, is a color bowl with a brush for application of the oil onto the hair. And then you need a processing cap, which I also include in every purchase. I include two processing caps. And then, of course, your Baze Hair RX formula of your choosing. Okay guys, so the first thing after you put your Baze Hair RX into a pot is to put it on the stove. You're gonna have it on low and stir just until the oil gets to a warm temperature. Not hot, hot, because you don't wanna burn yourself and it will break down the actual protein in the formula itself. I would not recommend doing this in the microwave because you have a little less control of how hot it gets. Also, the radiation will also break down those enzymes and proteins too. Oil treatment with Baze Hair RX. Client today has pretty dry, damaged hair. The ends are really damaged. So we're going to use the extra strength version of Baze Hair RX, which is infused with the vitamins A and E and the proteins to help rebuild the hair cuticle and the hair shaft. So this is just the texture you can see along the edges. It's kind of rough, kinky hair. It's dry. She does have some good moisture in the middle, but due to just heat damage and not taking good care of the hair, it ends up being broken on the ends. So when you start the Baze hot oil treatment, what I recommend obviously is test it on your skin first. Make sure it's not too hot. This is just warm. The reason why we heat it is it does help penetrate the hair cuticle to get inside of the strands of hair so that it can help restore the moisture and the vitamins that it's missing. So I use a color bowl and a brush, and I apply it just like you were to apply a color or a deep conditioning treatment. I always offer a client either a napkin or a piece of tissue because it does have a tendency to run, so this way they can catch it if it starts to. How you're going to apply it is you're going to separate the hair and go right down to the root part. So if you see I've spread her hair there, and you're going to apply it right at the root and then pull it through. Once you get it covering the whole scalp, then you can focus on pulling it all the way through to the ends. Her crown area is extra dry and there's a lot of dandruff in there. So I'll apply extra amount in there, and then before I wash it out, I'll make sure to use some friction and get in there and get that scalp clean. If you can't do this on your own with a color bowl and brush, or you just need an easier way, you can get an applicator bottle that just squirts on the hair, just like if you were to buy a store-bought color kit. And you can get all that kind of stuff at Sally's for a reasonable price. Okay. So I'm all finished putting the oil through her hair. I pulled it all the way through to the ends, and then I just kind of put it in a bun on the top of her head. And I put the processing cap over it to help hold the heat that comes off her scalp, and it'll help let that oil penetrate that hair cuticle even further. I will let her sit with this for at least 30 minutes. I understand people have busy lives and maybe don't have a lot of time, but 30 minutes will really get in the hair like we want it to. Even longer is even better. So sometimes when I use it on my own hair, I'll put it in and then I'll go do laundry and stuff for a couple hours sometimes before I wash it out. So we finished the hot oil treatment, and now I just shampooed and conditioned her hair. I shampooed twice because I used the extra strength version, which is a little heavier oil. And I don't want her hair to look weighed down when we're done. So I use Regis, it's called Design Line Olive Oil. I'm just giving a shout out because this is my absolute favorite for any texture of hair. And it's really done a lot to make my hair more healthy as well. So anyhow, just to give you an idea, this shampoo, conditioner, normal, and look. You can get right through it without any snags really. Before the treatment, this would have never been possible. So I'm going to go ahead and blow dry her hair with just a brush technique, and I'll show you the end results when I'm finished. Okay, so we just finished the blow dry, and I just want to show you guys the final results after the Bae's Hair RX Extra Strength Hot Oil Treatment. And so obviously it's a lot more moisturized. You can see it's not heavy, it's not weighed down, combs through very nicely, and it's very soft. How did you feel about it?
Really?
You like it? Soft and stuff. So this just gives you guys an idea of how you can use it. It can also be used on just dry hair if you just want to put your hair back in a ponytail. I have it in my hair right now. I just slick it back in a ponytail, and then the next time I wash it, it's like an oil treatment in itself. So there's a lot of things you can use it, a lot of ways you can use it. It's a makeup remover, you can actually put it on dry skin as well. So it's not specifically only for hair, but I just want to give you guys an idea. So I hope you enjoyed this video.